to dance in the streets, and people will be stopping and just amazed at what she can do.
I'm disappointed you didn't join in a little bit.
I was just pleased I could manage to get down there to talk to her.
Well, I'd show you my liberty, no doubt, but it's just not going to work in these shoes, is it? So we'll leave that for another time. Well, it has been a really miserable Monday, as I said earlier, at our official recording stations. We've had between about 6 and 21 millimetres of rain in the last 24 hours, and even when it wasn't pouring, it was rather grey, drizzly skies for much of the time. A distinct lack of sunshine here in sunny Sims Snap of Manningtree in Essex, and a similar story when this picture was taken at St Ives in Cambridgeshire. And this afternoon, we've had very cold air feeding down from the north, so it really has felt quite chilly out there, but it will be getting colder still, and I'll come to that in a moment. But through this evening and overnight, we'll continue to see some showers feeding in from the north and northeast. Some of those could be on the sharp side, but I think by morning, most of us should be dry. And under these clear skies, we're likely to see some frost with lows around 1 or 2 degrees Celsius in some spots. And it will be quite windy for a time around the coast. In fact, on the North Norfolk coast, we could see gusts in excess of 35 miles an hour. And then tomorrow, well, we've got quite a slack area of pressure over us, so this little feature working down the North Sea, bringing some showers Tuesday evening and night. Ahead of that little feature, though, we are likely during daylight hours tomorrow to see a few showers, but for most of us, a dry and much, much brighter day compared to today, with perhaps some unbroken sunshine for a time, especially in the afternoon. Temperatures, though, still struggling, only up to about 6 or 7 degrees Celsius, and those north and northwesterly winds, light to moderate in strength, not making it feel any warmer. And it's going to become even chillier from midweek as we keep these cold northerly winds. So on Wednesday, probably a widespread frost start the day, some mist and fog to clear, and any showers we get in Norfolk and Suffolk, that's where they're most likely, they could turn a bit wintry. But for many of us, again on Wednesday, a dry day, but temperatures really struggling, only up to about 4 to 6 degrees Celsius. The average for this time of year is around 10 Celsius, and it could be quite windy again for a time on Wednesday. Around the coast, gusts of about 25 to 30 miles an hour. And then we are expecting some wintry showers on Thursday and Friday. Highs of only 4 Celsius, and it's going to be really, really parky in those blustery winds. And perhaps some wintry showers over the weekend too, but a lot of fine and dry weather and less windy too. And look at these overnight lows. Widespread frosts on the way.
Not a huge fan of wintry showers, Jules.
No, it's a lot of frost.